Supriya Pasnur, working as an assistant professor in civil department from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today's class, we are going to discuss on stone masonry and the brick masonry walls. These are the learning outcomes. At the end of this session, students will be able to compare between the stone masonry and the brick masonry walls and its selection according to the construction work. Masonry is defined as an art of construction. This was the oldest method of the construction generally known to the humans. Masonry is the process of laying the masonry unit over another unit with the mortar to form a uniform bonding so that it can form an element of the building or a member of a building. It is commonly used for the masonry walls and the buildings. So there are different types of the masonry walls, as the stone masonry, the brick masonry, hollow block concrete masonry, the reinforced masonry, composite masonry. So out of this, we'll be studying about the stone masonry and the brick masonry. The stone masonry: the rock that is removed from its natural site and is used for the and is cut and dressed and finally finished for the building purpose is called as the stone. And the construction of the building structure with stones as a constructional unit is called as the stone masonry. Here you can see that the stone masonry is made up of the stone units bonded together with the mortar. There are different types of the stone masonries, as the rubble stone masonry and the ashlar masonry. So in the rubble masonry, the stones are either undressed or roughly dressed. And whereas in the ashlar masonry, the stones are finely dressed. So these are the different types of the rubble masonries, as the coarse rubble masonry. Second, you have the uncoarse rubble masonry. Third, the random rubble masonry. Fourth is the polygonal rubble masonry. Fifth is the flint rubble masonry. And finally, the dry rubble masonry. So let us see one by one. The coarse rubble masonry. So in this, we have the plan, the elevation of the courses, and the section is shown. So in this type, you can see that the stones, they are of different sizes. And even in the coarse rubble masonry, the masonry work is carried out in the courses. Here you can see that the stones which are used in the courses are of equal height. So they are used in the residential and the commercial constructions. So next we have the uncoarse rubble masonry. In this type of the masonry, you can see that there is no such courses maintained over here. So here you can see that the large stones are laid below, and over that the small chips of the stones, that is the spalls, they are filled in the spaces between the stones. This type of the masonry is used in the godowns, the garages, etc. Next we have the polygonal rubble masonry. In this type of the masonry, the stones are properly shaped to the polygonal shape, and here you can see that the small stones, that is the chips, are not used in this type of the masonry, and even the vertical joint is not maintained in this type of the masonry. Next we have the random rubble masonry. In this type of the masonry, the straight beds and the sides are used. The stones are properly shaped and the stones are square shaped in this type of the masonry. So this is the elevation, the section is shown, and this is the plan of the courses. Next we have the flint rubble masonry. So this type of the masonry is used where the flint stones are available in plenty. So the thickness of the flint stones is, it varies from 8 to 15 centimeter, whereas the length varies from 15 to 30 centimeter. Next we have the dry rubble masonry. So in this type of the masonry, the mortar is not used in this masonry. This is used for the construction of the retaining walls, the compound walls. Here it is used in the non-load bearing constructions. Next we have the types of the ashlar masonry. First we have the ashlar fine masonry. Second, the random coarse ashlar masonry. Third is the rough tooled ashlar masonry. Fourth is the rock or the quarry faced ashlar masonry. Next, we have the chamfered ashlar masonry. Now, again, further, we have the block in coarse masonry and ashlar facing. So, out of this, some of the masonries I will be discussing here. So, ashlar fine masonry. In this type of the masonry, the stones are finely chisel shaped, and this is costly in construction. And this type, you can see that the stones are of uniform size, that is the rectangular shape they are, and even the you have the horizontal and the vertical joints in between them. And whereas in the rough ashlar masonry, the stones are roughly dressed, and a 25 mm wide strip is used along the perimeter of the stones. The rock or the quarry faced. So this type of the masonry is similar to the rough ashlar masonry, but the remaining portion which is bought from the quarry, the stones are remained as it is. So next we have the chamfered ashlar masonry. So in this type of the masonry, the finely chisel shaped stones are laid below, and a 25 mm wide strip is used along the perimeter of the stones, and the stones are beveled at an angle of 45 degrees. Next we have the brick masonry. So based on the arrangement of the bricks, there are different types of the bonds in the brick masonry. The most commonly used out of that are the stretcher bond, the header bond. Next we have the English bond and the Flemish bond. So next let's see one by one. The stretcher bond. The brick, the longer face of the brick is called as the stretcher, and the vertical face of the wall is called as the header. The brick size, this is the elevation and this is the plan of the courses. So each course is given as the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So this is the courses, this is the plan of the courses as 1, 3 and 5. So this type of the bond is used for the 9 cm thick wall. If the thickness of the wall is more than 9 cm, this type of bond is not at all used. So the courses, in these courses you can see that the bricks are laid with their length in the direction of the wall. Next we have the header bond. So this is the header bond. A 3/4 bat is used before starting the header in the header bond. So this type of the bond is used for the one brick thick wall. And here you can see that it is of 18 cm thickness of the wall. Next we have the English bond. It consists of the alternate courses of the stretcher bond and the header bond. So in the header bond you can see that a twin closure is placed after a header in the header course. So the twin closure is placed due to break the continuity of the joint, a vertical joint which is maintained. And the header course, this is the plan of the stretcher course, the plan of the header course, the face and the back, which are the outer appearance of the wall, and back is the inner appearance of the wall. Next we have, this is the plan for the odd courses of the wall, and this is the plan of the even courses of the wall. So here you can see that the face and the back, the appearance of the wall represents the stretcher bond, which is the similar appearance from both the faces. So this is in the case of the odd courses, whereas in the header bond, it represents the header bond in both the walls, that is the back and the face wall. Whereas in the stretcher course, the plan of the stretcher course, here you can see that in 1.5 brick thick wall, here the appearance of the wall, that is the face, it represents the stretcher bond, whereas the back represents the header bond. So it is a combination of the header and the stretcher bond, and here it is the similar is the for the header course. The back, that is the inner face of the wall, represents the stretcher bond, whereas the outer face of the wall represents the header bond, that is it represents the English bond and English bond, which is nothing but a alternate stretcher and the header course. Next we have the single and the double Flemish bond. So this is the plan of the single Flemish bond. It is used for the appearance of the wall. Here you can see a stretcher is placed and then a header is placed. That is, it consists of the stretcher and a header in a particular course. So this type of the wall is used for the minimum 1.5 brick thick wall. So this is the plan for the odd courses, and this is for the even courses. That is, it represents the same appearance. It is used for the aesthetic look of the wall. This type of the wall gives a pleasing appearance of the wall. So it is a combination of the English bond and the Flemish bond. So here we have the comparison between the brick masonry and the stone masonry. The brick masonry is that in which the bricks are used, whereas in the stone masonry, the stone blocks are used. The brick masonry is cheaper than the stone masonry because the bricks can easily be lifted to the side, whereas in the stone, the labor and more skills and labors are used for the lifting of the stone. The brick masonry requires less mortar, whereas the stone masonry requires mortar, which cannot be easily estimated. The dead load of the stone masonry is more, whereas the dead load of the brick masonry is less. The life of the brick masonry is less as compared to the stone masonry. So here you can select the correct answer for these questions. The stones which are placed at the regular interval right across the wall are known as spalls, through stones, the rivels, the springer. This is the right answer for that. Next, what should be the placed at the beginning of every header course in the English bond to avoid the vertical joint? The queen closer, half bat, 3/4 bat, and the king closer. This is the right answer for that. These are the references. Thank you.